Hi guys, this what you see is a 1.5 HP 4000 RPM permanent magnet DC motor. It is very heavy with this flywheel. So guys, today in this video I'm going to test its regenerative braking. This is a 180 volts 1500 watts DC motor speed controller, low high. Let's connect it to this motor. Everything is well connected. All I have to do is turn on the switch. Now guys, here as you can see, I have stripped the wires a little on both red and black. So I am going to connect the load terminals and the multimeter terminals to this wire, so that when I disconnect it from this motor controller, I don't have to connect the appliance after disconnection, because it is going to be very dangerous. Now guys, to make sure that the meter has been electrically connected properly here and there to this motor, let's turn it on, pointing it towards 20 volts DC mode, and I'm going to run this inertia disk to see if this display indicates some voltage. You see, voltage is being displayed. So yeah, it's electrically connected. Now guys, let's connect it to the converter and turn the setup on. So guys, as you can see that it has been connected. All I have to do is switch it on and then remove the wires of this motor from the converter and then see how much voltage is being displayed on the multimeter screen, and that voltage will be the braking generation. Okay, first pointing it towards 1000 volts. Okay, go. 75-76 volts, increasing the voltage. 100 volts more. 130 volts high speed, a little more. As you can see that it is flashing 180 volts almost. Now let's disconnect the terminals from the converter and see how the voltage falls. The disk, inertia disk, has been charged completely. You can see the disk has been charged, wires have been disconnected, and the voltage is slowly and slowly decreasing to zero, but it is still charged. Very dangerous. Still running. Now let's force stop the disk. And zero. Now guys, here I have not connected the black wire to this blue wire of this 100 watts incandescent bulb that we use in our houses. So anyways, let's charge this inertia disk of this motor. Okay, turning it on now. Let's increase the speed a little bit. At present, I'm working with this setup at 50% power mode. Now let's disconnect the wires and touch this blue wire of this bulb, left out wire, to the black. And let's hope that this bulb glows. Okay. Wire disconnected. You see, the bulb is glowing 100 watts. Slowly, the illuminance is decreasing, of course. Let's brake stop it. Stop. Now guys, let's try this 500 watts energy wasting halogen. Okay? Let's start. Increasing the speed. ...75% of power being fed to this motor. Like the wind pressure is towards this side. Let's turn it off. Okay. Boom. Wow. That was really bright. You can imagine how much energy was stored in the inertia disk. And guys, now comes the 1.5 kilowatt halogen, 1500 watts. I've never seen such a halogen. And guys, size of a 500 watts halogen is this, and this is 1500. You see, it's 3 times the size of this. So guys, now this motor is going to be fully loaded during regenerative braking. Let's connect this. Okay. And finally this terminal, and it should glow. Connecting the motor terminals to the converter. Okay, one done. Second also done. Let's keep it a little apart. Yeah, this much is fine. Let's turn it on. Okay, go. Increasing the speed. 50%. 75%. Power. Now let's disconnect it. I have to be quick. Oh, let's hold it. Oh, cool. So guys, actually the halogen was on the white chart paper, so its visibility was not that good. So I have placed it like this for you to see it better. Okay, so let's get started. And guys, this time I'm going to turn it off from here and not disconnect the wires. Okay, you have already got the point. So it started. Let's increase the speed. 25%, 50, 75, 85%, good enough. Turning it off, let's connect this wire. Whoa. Cool. I connected this wire to the vise, because it is electrically connected to this halogen. Let's give it one more try. Bringing it back to zero, turning it on. Yeah, actually there was a lot of spark between the clip and the vise, so I think I should better place this directly to the other terminal of the halogen. Zero. Started. Okay. Much brighter now. So cool. I forgot to bring it down to zero and I mistakenly turned it on. And guys, before finishing off the video, I also wanted to test if this regenerative braking energy is enough to start an angle grinder and run it. So let's check that out. Hey guys, I've connected the angle grinder. You can see these wires connected to this pin, which is the wire for the angle grinder here. Okay, yeah, make sure that it is always turned off. Yeah, it is off. Okay, yeah, this is the last one. I'm going to finish off the video after this. Connected. Everything safe and sound. Pointer at zero. Turning it on. Increasing the speed. Turning it off. Off. So powerful. Really good. That was really nice. It is slowly decreasing the speed.
Well guys, my neighbors are having a party. I'm not invited. That's why they are shouting. But anyways, I'm here with you guys.